how are you? I hope you are doing well and I am also doing good. So, in the previous class, we had discussed about the poem, The Tease. Our first lesson from our 10 plus 2 is The Tease. It's a poem and it's written by Lilian Holmes. Who is the author of the poem? Lilian Holmes. The title of the poem is The Tease. The title of the poem is The Tease and the author of the poem is Lilian Holmes. Look at the spelling. Lilian Holmes. L-I-L-L-I-A-N. Lilian. H-O-L-M-E-S. Lilian Holmes. Lilian Holmes is the author of the poem The Tease. The title of the poem is The Tease and the author of the poem is Lilian Holmes. Okay. This speaker of the poem is, that means it is spoken by a little girl. The speaker of the poem is a little girl, and here different types of wind is described in this poem. Different types of wind is described in the poem. First type is breeze. The first one is B-R-R-E-Z-E, breeze. And the second form, much more faster than breeze, is called a wind. Second form is wind. Then the third form is storm. S-T-O-R-M, storm. Then the fourth form, the dangerous form of wind is cyclone. C-Y-C-L-O-N-E, cyclone. According to their speed, or how they are fast, wind is divided into some categories. The first one, slowest wind is breeze, then wind. Hard, heavy wind is storm, then dangerous wind is cyclone. These are the forms of wind. These are the types of wind according to their speed. This is categorized according to their speed. Breeze is very slow wind is called a breeze. Very slow wind is called a breeze. Then wind. Heavy wind is called a storm. Heavy wind is called when there is a raining and a heavy wind and thunderstorms. There are storms, and in storms some trees fell down, and there may be some other dangerous things happen in storms. And heavy, very dangerous storm is called, very dangerous wind is called a cyclone. Very dangerous wind is called a cyclone. Here, unscramble the word and find the hidden names of wind depending on its speed. Here we unscrambled in the previous class. This is breeze, this is storm, and the last one is cyclone. And I read this poem once more. You are a nuisance, I declare. You tease me so, it isn't fair. You pounce on me from everywhere and seize my hat and clutch my hair and tie my nose in knots and tear the leaves and blossom from the pear. This is the first answer. These six lines are the first answer, and I will explain once more. You are a nuisance in the poem. This is the speaker. Who is the speaker of the poem? A little girl is the speaker of the poem. And in the first answer, the little girl is much annoyed by the naughtiness of the wind. It is annoyed by the naughtiness of the wind. The wind is disturbing her. The wind is disturbing her in so many ways. Which are the ways? The wind became a nuisance to the child. The wind became a nuisance. N-U-I-S-A-N-C-E. Nuisance to the child. The wind is described as a nuisance to the child. The wind is described as a nuisance to the child. And later, what are the things the wind do? The wind teases the child. The wind teases. T-E-A-S-E-S. T-E-A-S-E-S. Teases. Meaning, made fun of or ridicule or provoke. Meaning of teases is make fun of, ridicule or provoke. The wind teases the child. The wind teases the child. Which are the ways the wind teases the child? The wind teases the child in so many ways. The wind teases the child in so many ways. Which are the different ways? The wind pounces the child from everywhere. The wind pounces the child. P-O-U-N-C-E. Pounces the child from everywhere. The wind pumps the child from everywhere. The child is pounced by the wind. The child is pounced by the wind. By every side, the wind is pouncing the child from left, right, up and downward. The wind is pouncing the child. The child is much annoyed by the disturbances caused by the wind. The child is disturbed by the wind, the naughtiness of the wind. Then the wind seizes her heart. The wind seizes, S-E-I-Z-E-S. The wind seizes her heart. H-E-R, her heart. The wind seizes her heart. First thing is the wind pounds the child from everywhere. Then the second thing is the wind seizes her heart. The wind seizes her heart. The third thing is the wind clutched her hair. Clutched her hair. The wind clutched her hair, seizes her hat and clutched her hair, then tie her clothes in knots, which is the next one. Wind tied her clothes in knots, T-I-E-D, tied her clothes, C-L-O-T-H-E-S, clothes in knots, K-N-O-T-S, K-N-O-T-S. Tied her clothes in knots, which is the other way. The wind tear the blossom and leaves from the pear. Tear, T-E-A-R. Tear the blossom and leaves. Blossom and leaves from the pear. Blossom and leaves. L-E-A-V-E-S. It is a plural noun. L-E-A-F leaf. L-E-A-V-E-S leaves. Tear the blossom and leaves from the pear, from the pear. Okay, listen here. The wind is the thing that disturbs the child in the first stanza. In the first stanza, we can see that the child is disturbed by the wind. How does the wind disturb the child, or which are the ways the wind disturb the child? The first one is the wind teases her. The wind teases her. Teases her means made fun of her or provoke her. The wind teases her. Then next one, the wind pounces the child from everywhere. The wind pounces the child from everywhere. Next one, the wind seizes her hat. Seize means S-E-I-Z-E, seize. What is the meaning of seize? Taking something using force. It's taking something from someone by using force is called seize. The wind seizes her hat. Then which is the other thing? The wind clutched her hair. The wind clutched her hair. And the next one, tied her clothes in knots. The wind tied her clothes in knots. And the wind tear the blossom and leaves from the pear. Wind tear the blossom and leaves from the pear. These are the things the wind disturbs the child. In the first stanza, the wind is very heavy and the wind disturbs the child in so many ways that we can see in the first stanza. And now, I will read the first stanza once more. You are a nuisance, I declare. You tease me so, it isn't fair. You pounce on me from everywhere and seize my hat and clutch my hair and tie my clothes in knots and tear the leaves and blossom from the pear. Is it clear? Do you know how to read the poem? Yes. Then let us move on to the next stanza. In the next stanza, the wind is very mild, the wind is calm, and the child is very happy now. The child is very happy. In the first stanza, the child is annoyed, the child is disturbed by the wind. And in the second stanza, the child is very happy. In the second stanza, the child is very happy. I wish that I could set a snare. Here the child is happily saying, I wish. I wish means I like. I like. I wish I can set a snare. Snare means snare. What is the meaning of snare? Trap. I can set a trap to catch the wind. What did the child want to do? The child wanted to catch the wind using a snare. S N A R E, snare. It's a new word. S N A R E, snare. S N A R E, snare. The child wanted to catch the wind using a snare. Snare means trap. I wish that I could set a snare to catch you, but I shouldn't dare. I don't have the courage to do so. The child is saying, I want to catch you in a snare. I want to catch you, the wind. I want to catch you in a snare, but I don't have the courage to do so. But I don't dare. I shouldn't dare. For though you tease me, although you are always in the previous stanza, we saw that the wind is teasing the child. Although the wind is teasing the child, the child is not angry with the wind. Although the wind is teasing, for though you tease me, I declare, O wind, if you were never there, if you were not in the atmosphere, the wind is not in the atmosphere, I don't think I manage quiet. I don't think without you we cannot exist. Without you, I cannot exist. I think that without you there is no fun in living. Without you there is no fun in living. To sail my boat or fly my kite. For sailing the boat and flying the kite, we need wind. If there is no wind, the kite will not fly. If there is no wind, the kite will not fly. If there is no wind, the kite will not fly. Fly my kite. Fly my kite. Fly my kite. And sail my boat. S-A-I-L. Sail my boat. B-O-A-T. For flying my kite and sailing my boat, I need your help. I need your help. The child is telling the wind. The child is telling the wind that for sailing my boat in the sea, if there is no wind, there may not be any waves in the water. There may not be any waves in the water. So I couldn't sail my boat. Sail my boat. The boat will be stuck there. If there is wind, there will form waves and the boat will move swiftly through the water. Then only I can sail my boat. If there is no wind, I couldn't fly my kite. If there is, that means the child cannot think of a situation where there is no wind. The child likes the wind in the second stanza and the child is saying that I like to catch the wind using a snare, but I don't have the courage to do so. So the child is saying that without the wind, she could not fly her kite. Without the wind, she could not fly her kite or sail her boat. This is the point. I will read the second stanza once more. I wish that I could set a snare to catch you, but I shouldn't dare. For though you tease me, I declare, O wind, if you were never there, I don't think I could manage quiet to sail my boat or fly my kite. Lillian Holmes is the author of the poem. Next, let us move on to the vocabulary. First word, nuisance. Meaning of nuisance, something that causes problems. Pounce means jump. Clutch, hold tightly. Snare, trap. S-N-A-R-E, snare, trap. Then, make sentences from the given words. Sentence making. Next segment is sentence making. The gardener
made a snare, made a snare to catch insects. Look here, which is the sentence made by using the word snare? Snare means trap. The gardener made a snare to catch insects. The gardener, G-A-R-D-E-N-E-R, gardener, M-A-D-E, made a snare, S-N-A-R-E, snare, to catch insects. For what the gardener made a snare? To catch insects. The gardener made a snare to catch insects. Next word, pounce. Pounce. Second one, P-O-U-N-C-E. Pounce. What is the meaning of pounce? Pounce means jump. My ball. Here is the sentence. My ball pounced on the wall. Pounced on the wall. P-O-U-N-C-E-D. Pounced. My ball pounced on the wall and came to me and returned to me and returned to me. The ball pounced on the wall and returned to me. The ball pounced on the wall and returned to me. The ball pounced on the wall and returned to me. The next word is clutch. Clutch. Third one, clutch. C-L-U-T-C-H. C-L-U-T-C-H. Clutch. Clutch means hold tightly. The baby clutched his mother's shawl. Then nuisance. Next word is nuisance. N-U-I-S-A-N-C-E. Nuisance. N-U-I-S-A-N-C-E. Nuisance. Sometimes, our friends, F-R-I-E-N-D-S, friends, become nuisance to us. N-U-I-S-N-C-E, nuisance to us. Some days, our friends become nuisance to us. Sometimes our friends become nuisance to us. These are the words for sentence making and we made sentences using the forward snare. The gardener made a snare to catch insects. Then pounce, my ball pounced on the wall and returned to me. Then press, the baby pressed on his mother's shawl. Nuisance, sometimes our friends become nuisance to us. Okay, let us move on to the next segment. Next one, pick the correct answer. The poem is
about Winch, a naughty boy. Which option is correct? Two options are there. The poem is about Winch, a naughty boy. Which one is correct? Winch. The first option. You tick the first option. The poem is about Winch. The poem is about Winch. Next, second one. The wind talks to the child, entangles her claws onto her leaves. Which one is correct? The wind entangles her claws and tear leaves. The second option is correct. You tick the second option. The wind entangles her claws and tear leaves. That one is correct. Third one. Though a nuisance, the child loves the wind or can fly his kites without it. Which one is correct? First option is correct. Third one. First option is correct. Though a nuisance, the child loves the wind. Though the wind is a nuisance, she loves the wind. Though the wind is a nuisance, the child loves it. First option is correct. Then I will read the correct option. First one, the poem is about wind. Second one, the wind entangles her claws and tears leaves. Third one, though a nuisance, the child loves the wind. Then take the next page, page number 10. Here is a writing section. Wind is called by different names because of the speed at which it blows. Wind is called by different names. Wind is called by different ways, different names according to their speed. A slow wind is called on one name, a heavy wind is called on another name, and a dangerous wind is called by another name. Like that, wind is called by different names according to its speed. Can you name the different types of wind? First one is breeze or wind. Under the first here is three pictures are given in the text, and the first one is wind or breeze. B R E E is a deep breeze. First one is B R E E is a deep breeze. Under the first picture, you write the word breeze. B R E E is a deep breeze. B R E E is a deep breeze. In the second picture, you can write storm. S T O R M. Storm. Second picture. Storm. S T O R M. Storm. Under the second picture, you write the word storm. The third picture is cyclone. C Y C L O N E. C Y C L O N E. Cyclone. C Y C L O N E. Cyclone. C Y C L O N E. Cyclone. Find out the different names by which the wind is referred to. Example, wind. Wind. Then air. Air. Breeze. Then storm. Next one, cyclone. C Y C L O N E. Cyclone. C Y C L O N E. Cyclone. Which are the forms of wind? Air, breeze, wind, storm, cyclone. These are the forms of wind. These are the forms of wind. Next one, let us study some grammar. Conjunctions. Our topic is conjunction. C O N J U C O N J U N C T I O N S. C O N J U N C T I O N S. Conjunctions. Conjunctions. Text page number 10. Conjunctions. What is the meaning of conjunctions? Conjunctions means connecting words. Conjunctions means connecting words. A conjunction is used to connect two nouns, other part of the sentence, etc. Two parts of the sentence, etc. or two sentences. Using by using conjunctions we can connect two words, two part of a sentence or two separate sentences. We can connect two separate sentences by using a conjunction. We use, which are the conjunctions we use? And, the first one is, and is a conjunction. Then, but is a conjunction. And which is the other one? Or is a conjunction. Or. Here, there are so many other conjunctions, but here in this chapter we are studying the conjunctions and, but, or. These are the conjunctions we are going to study about. Then, in the following sentence, Meena came to play. Here is an example. Meena, M-E-E-N-A. Meena came to play. C-A-M-E-K-M-T-O, to play. Meena came to play. Next one, Radha came to play. Next sentence, Radha came to play. Radha came to play. Here in the first sentence, Meena came to play, then Radha came to play. Then Meena and Radha are two nouns. They are doing the same thing. Then we can connect the two nouns together and make it a sentence. Join this sentence. Connect these sentences together. Meena and Radha. Meena and Radha came to play. Like this, we can connect two sentences using the conjunction and. Here, the conjunction we use is and. By using and, we connect two sentences. Meena came to play. Then the second is, Radha came to play. We made it as one sentence. Meena and Radha came to play. This is the use of conjunction or connecting word. Next one. Dinesh is tall. Second example. Dinesh is tall. Dinesh is tall. He is obese. He is obese. First sentence, Danish is tall. It describes the quality of a boy, Danish. And in the second sentence also describes his own quality, that he is obese. Then we can join the last part of these two sentences. Danish is tall but obese. Danish is tall. We can connect the sentence using but. Danish is tall but obese. Danish is tall but he is obese. Danish is tall but obese. The connecting word or conjunction used here is but. Okay, I hope you understood this. We might go to Shimla, we might go to Kashmir. This is the third example. We might go to Shimla or Kashmir. Look at this example, third one. We might go to Shimla, we might go to Shimla. Next sentence, we might go to Kashmir. We might go to Kashmir. We can join this sentence using or. We might go to Shimla or Kashmir. There is no need to repeat these words. We might go to Shimla. Look here. We might go to Shimla or, it is a choice, or Kashmir. A-S-H-M-I-R, Kashmir. Then, which is the conjunction used? condition used to join these two sentences. What is the condition that is used to join these two sentences? Which are the conditions we studied now? And, but, or. And, but, or. Okay, join sentences using conjunctions. Next is an exercise. You do it in your own book and take a photograph of that page and send it to me. Okay, this is a work for you. This is a work given to you. Page number 11. Page number 11. You should write all these sentences. You should connect all these sentences using the conjunctions and, but, and, or, and send me. Okay. Then let us move on to the pronunciation. I will explain how you can write. Meeta went to her room and sat on the bed. The conjunction we use is and. The conjunction we use is and. Next example. Neetu failed her examinations. Second one. Neetu. Neetu. N-E-E-T-U. Neetu. Neetu failed her examinations. Failed her examinations. E-X-A-M-I-N-A-T-I-O-N-S. Neetu failed her examinations. Next sentence. She did not give up. She did not give up. These are the two sentences. Neetu failed her examinations. She did not give up. Neetu failed her examinations. Answer. Neetu failed her examinations. Failed her examinations. 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 But did not give up. But did not give up. Neetu failed her examinations but did not give up. Next one. Walk fast, you will miss the train. Third one. Walk fast. Walk. F-A-S-T. Fast. Full stop. You will miss the train. You will miss the train. These are the two or the contention is or, you will miss the train. You will miss the train. Walk fast or you will miss the train. Walk fast or you will miss the train. Next sentence, you can play. You can play You can take rest. You can take rest. You can play. You can take rest. Which one is used? You can play or take rest. You can play. Play or take rest. Take rest. You can play or take rest. Next one, fifth one. Nat was hungry. Nat was hungry. N-A-T, Nat. It is a name. Nat was hungry. H-U-N-G-R-Y. Hungry. Nat was hungry. He looked in the fridge for something to eat. He looked in the fridge. He looked in the fridge. For something to eat. For something to eat. Nat was hungry. He looked in the fridge for something to eat. How can we join these sentences? Nat was hungry and looked in the fridge. And looked in the fridge. Nat was hungry. Hungry. And looked in the fridge. Looked in the fridge. Conjunctions. Which are the conjunctions we studied today? And, but, and or. These and, but, or. These are the three conjunctions we studied today. And you study it on the same day itself when class comes to you. And then you can be easy. It is very easy for you to learn conjunctions. What is conjunction? Conjunction is a connecting word that we used to connect two nouns, two parts of a sentence or two sentences. Connecting words are called conjunctions. And, but, or are conjunctions. And in using these three words, we can connect sentences. Okay? I hope you all understand and you studied on the same day when the class comes to you. Wish you all the best. Today, let us stop here and continue in the next class.